Hi everybody, it's Louise McKay with Louise McKay Art, and I'm going to be going in a little different direction today from the Cloud Pearl Pour, which used probably the thinnest consistency paint around, to the Deconstructed Bloom, which requires the Bloom Pillow and paints that is probably the thickest paints around. I seem to want to play the whole gamut. So with my pillow here, I've got my Glidden Essentials Eggshell, and this is a recipe from Karen Dershwin from Waterfall Acrylics. So basically it's about 5% GAC and the rest house paint, and it's very, very thick. So when you pour, it's about a 5-second trace before it sinks back into the rest of the paint. And then for my colors, I've got gold, and this is my Deco Art Iridescent Gold. I'm not going to stir it up anymore because it's already got bubbles in it. This is bronze, and this is a mixture of Golden's bronze with Modern Masters bronze. And this pink here is my Arteza's Pearl Rose. And this green here is Arteza's Pistachio Green. Just so you know, one of the things you can do to try to pop the bubbles is you just drop it hard on a flat surface, and it helps bring up the air bubbles. Just a little tip that I learned from everybody else. So with that, I'm going to get started here in a second. And all the background music, noise I mean, I have to apologize. It's the school behind my house, and I can't stop it. There's always something going on over there. So bear with me and we'll get down to pouring. All right, so I laid down the base. I don't think you need to watch me do that. As usual, I've got bubbles. And when I do the Deconstructed Bloom, I like to start in the center. For some reason, it just makes me feel more comfortable starting in the middle and working my way to the edges. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start in the middle. Starting with my gold. I gotta remember, I gotta lay down a lot more paint with this technique than with the pearl pour. So I gotta get this paint to get to the edges, and with this thick base, it doesn't spread as quickly. So. My gold. Now I'm going to go to bronze. All right, now to the pink, the Arteza's Rose. Pearl Rose. And I know most people like to just layer their paints down straight on top of each other. I don't know why, but I like to do it this way. It just kind of feels like all the paints are going to be represented better. It's just my way. Probably no validity to what I just said. And then I'm going to put down my green. And then at the very end, I'm going to lay down a little more gold. And then the cell activators, which I've got two today. I've got my black and my white. And I haven't done this technique in a few months, so cross my fingers on this. I did do a couple test tiles, which I may or may not post. All right, back to a little bit of gold in the center. then I'm gonna lay down my cell activator. Okay, now I'm gonna lay down white first and then black. Didn't want to have an errant drop. Arr! My black is disappearing pretty quickly into that white. All right, here we go. Bottoms up. Seems as though I'm a little off as far as my balance, but I know I leveled this thing beforehand, but I don't want everything going off that edge, so I'm going to put sticks in there for right now. Okay, so now on the next one.
Thank you. It's here where I realize the black cell activator is going to ruin this, so I'm going to fast forward to when I have a new base laid down using some of the scraps from this pour. Okay, I'm back after salvaging as much of the base as I could and adding a little more fresh paint, and I also thickened up the cell activator by adding more black oxide to it. So I'm going to speed up the video and add some music and move this thing along. I decided for this try, I was going to put a second layer of bronze down right before the black cell activator, and this time only use black cell activator. Thank you.